For animation, having real-time viewport playback is always the goal. However, look at these two videos. It is the same scene with the same objects, exactly the same polygon count, and playing the same animation. Yet the one on the left is running at about half the FPS compared to the right. Would you believe that the performance hit is due to a single misplaced custom property and driver? Let's find out why. For character models, a subdivision modifier is often used to smooth things out. This is, however, likely to slow playback performance. Therefore, most of the time, while animating, it is set to zero. But at times, even in pose mode, you want a quick check of how it all looks at a higher resolution. Normally, this would mean selecting each object, scrolling through the modifier stack, and increasing viewport levels. What if, instead, a few custom properties were created on the collection object, and then a driver was used to adjust one or more subdivision modifiers with a single click? Well, it turns out that is a very bad idea. With just a single driver connected to the custom collection property, the playback speed drops significantly. The moment that the driver is deleted, we instantly jump to the set 24 frames per second. Having additional properties and drivers makes little extra difference. The real damage is done by just connecting any driver. The solution is, instead of adding the custom properties to the collection, we add them to the specific object. In this case, we have used the main body mesh object and then added a driver to the subdivision modifier on the same modifier stack. In turn, additional custom modifiers can be linked up to modifiers in the stack of other objects, such as the boots. Playing back the animation now, and even with those custom properties in place, we still get the full playback speed. Any adjustment in those values now only impact the playback speed due to the fact we are changing the levels of a subdivision modifier on those objects. So while my system can handle a level of 1 for the main character body, the increased polygon count of 2 subdivision levels is just too much. Hence the playback speed drops to half of the set rate. While grouping various settings in one spot is useful, unfortunately you can't access them while animating in pose mode. The collection ones you can, but as we now know, that kills playback performance. However, the object-based ones you can't, as the interface is locked to the armature while in pose mode. You could tab out, select the body object, change a setting, and tab back to pose mode, but that's really annoying. One solution to this issue is to use a little Python scripting to create a custom UI. It doesn't have to be anything fancy, just a reference to the custom properties we have already set up. So now, when the character is in pose mode, just like we already have various rigify options in the sidebar, there is another tab that provides additional settings. No longer does one have to drop out of pose mode to adjust the subdivision level, and playback speed is unaffected by the custom properties. I hope this short video shows just how one little thing in the wrong place can really impact performance. Hence, it is important to test changes rather than think that maybe you just need faster hardware. Thanks to everyone that has hit like, watched my videos, and/or subscribed. I hope to see you for the next one. Cheers.